This video will go over the steps on how US merchants can add Amazon Pay to their website if they're not using an e-commerce provider. We'll show you how to configure the Amazon Pay checkout session, the API object you will use to manage the buyer's active session on your website, and how to render the Amazon Pay button. At the end of this video, you'll be able to redirect the buyer to an Amazon Pay hosted page where they can select their preferred shipping address and payment instrument, redirect back to your order review page, and place an order. You can visit pay.amazon.com/integration for a list of supported e-commerce providers. Before you start, make sure these items are complete. You must have an Amazon Pay merchant account. If you don't have an Amazon Pay merchant account, watch our video, Registering for Amazon Pay, or visit our Get Setup integration guide using the link below. Next, you must add all the domains, including the protocol and custom ports that you plan on using for the Amazon Pay checkout, to the JavaScript origins in Seller Central. For instructions, please watch the video, Creating a Client ID or Store ID in Seller Central. You must create a test buyer account in Sandbox. You will use Sandbox to conduct end-to-end tests of your integration before going live. For instructions, please watch the video, Creating a Test Buyer Account in Sandbox. For more information on testing, visit the link below. You must download the Amazon Pay SDK if one is available for your programming language. Visit our GitHub link below for the list of available Amazon Pay SDKs. Finally, you must get your public key ID. To do so, navigate to the Integration tab in Seller Central and select Integration Central from the drop-down list. First, select Self-Developed Integration. Click Get Instructions. This will reveal the API Access section. Then, click Create Keys under Create API Keys. Select Generate API Credentials. Name your API keys. Then click Create Keys. The private key will be downloaded to your browser. You'll need the private key for your integration. You should never share your private key with anyone. If you accidentally share the private key, delete the key and generate a new one. You can copy your public key ID here. Click See Details to access more credentials or download the JSON file. After completing all these steps, you are now ready to add the Amazon Pay button for buyer authentication to your cart page. Let's look at the required steps to take your integration live. Step 1. Add the Amazon Pay script. Step 2. Generate the Create Checkout Session payload. Step 3. Sign the payload. And Step 4. Render the Amazon Pay button. Now let's go over the steps in detail. Step 1. Add the checkout.js script to your web pages as shown here. Step 2. Generate the Create Checkout Session payload by providing a payload as shown here. Amazon will use this to create a checkout session object. You will use the checkout session object to manage the buyer's active session on your website. Visit the link below for our checkout session guide. In the payload, set the checkout review return URL parameter to the URL that the buyer is redirected to after they select their preferred shipping address and payment method. When you create a checkout session, you can use the delivery specifications parameter to specify shipping restrictions and prevent buyers from selecting unsupported addresses from their Amazon address book. Visit our guide for shipping address restriction samples using the link below. Step 3. Sign the payload. Generate a signature using the helper function provided in the Amazon Pay SDKs. The signature generated by the helper function is only valid for the button and not for the API requests. A link to our signature tool is available below. Step 4. Render the Amazon Pay button. Use the values from steps 2 and 3 to render the Amazon Pay button to an HTML container element. This is a sample cart page with the Amazon Pay button rendered. After the buyer is successfully authenticated, shipping address and payment methods are presented for selection. After the buyer selects their preferred shipping address and payment method, the buyer will be redirected to your site after clicking the Continue button. update checkout session to set payment info, such as the order amount and transaction metadata. Set charge amount to the value that should be processed using the payment intent during checkout. Use the checkout result return URL parameter to specify the URL the buyer is redirected to after checkout is completed on the Amazon Pay hosted page. Once you've set all mandatory parameters, update checkout session will return a unique Amazon Pay redirect URL. When the buyer clicks place order on your site, you should redirect them to the Amazon Pay hosted page. Also, note the following. The buyer is redirected to checkout result return URL after Amazon Pay has processed the transaction. In this step, you'll use the checkout session ID to confirm that the buyer has successfully returned to your site and finalized the payment intent. Use complete checkout session to confirm that the buyer has successfully returned to your site. Note, Amazon Pay will not finalize the payment intent until you confirm checkout with complete checkout session. Here's a sample confirmation page where your buyer is redirected. Lastly, we'll look at how to handle the response. If payment intent is authorized with capture, then store charge ID to process refunds. If payment intent is authorized, then store charge ID and charge permission ID to capture the authorized amount. Store charge permission ID if there is an uncaptured payment. Now you're ready to take your integration live. Update the button rendering code and replace the public key ID with a live API public key ID. And that wraps up our custom integration video. Be sure to check out our Amazon Pay University channel for other custom integration videos.